So, just a bit of a little introduction to me. I'm George. I'm a product manager here at Zappar, and I'll be in the background hiding and manning the chat. And Ollie is here with me from Tiny Social and an ex-Zappar employee. And he's going to be taking you through for the next half an hour how to create viral AR experiences. So take it away, Ollie.
Hey everyone, thanks you all so much, George. Yeah, great to see you. I'm going to be talking about creating viral AR experiences, as George said, aka the art of making your ads feel organic. So a bit about me. I'm a professional, somewhat professional creator from London, although I'm always traveling. I'm never really in the same place. I'm currently down in Brighton. Here's some pictures of me on screen if you can't see me on chat. But some background of why I'm qualified to talk about this. I have a 15 plus billion filter views, that's billion with a B, over all my social platforms, all that kind of fun stuff. I have over 100,000 followers on my social platforms. So if you care about that kind of stuff, I've got that. I was previously an AR dev at Zappa, so which is why it's great for Zappa to host me. And I was also previously the AR development lead over at Poplar Studio, as Joe mentioned in the chat. So, it's great to be here. I'm now currently a founder of Tiny Social and Tapaday, which is a daily mini game app where you play mini games every single day. And also, Tiny Social, where you get to make a bunch of AR experiences. I also do a bunch of consultancy and creative bits and pieces too. But first and foremost, I am a filter creator. I'm going to run you through a few little filters that I've created that have got a bunch of engagement over the years. Starting off with this beans filter that I made for Snapchat using Snapchat's machine learning tools. This went crazy viral on Snapchat back in the day, and it was sort of a first experiment on using machine learning with Snapchat. And it didn't really have much sort of goals or aims towards it, but it will come in handy later, so keep this in mind. Next up is one I made working with Louis Theroux and Jason Derulo, weirdly enough. It was for the song Jiggle Jiggle, which went super viral on TikTok. And this essentially had you driving around in the car used on the album art and placed you in this tiny little car, which you could drive around while Jiggle Jiggle played in the background. Here's one that went super viral on TikTok, which was the crying eyes filter. We paired this with the music from Tracy Beaker that goes like, it's like, what's the matter? Just hay fever. And it went super viral and it was used for storytelling all over and got billions and billions of views. And then there's just a bunch of my other randomizers type things, like my red flags filter or the star sign guesser, or things like even just the Minecraft doors guesser that went was all around LinkedIn earlier on. So what are we doing today? First of all, I'm going to be talking to you about some key factors that make campaigns exciting. As you can see, Lizzo getting very excited about one of my filters there. Number two, tearing down the demo campaign to give it more viral potential. And number three, just walking you through a general Q&A of what we're doing. So, first of all, what are some key factors to keep in mind with when you're making a viral or potentially viral project, aka things every single AR campaign should have, in my opinion? First of all, I want you to be telling a story. This doesn't need to be anything crazy. This doesn't need to be a Lord of the Rings, but it just needs to give some more context and make it more shareable. So, the things on the left and the right, one was for Tom Grennan, one was for another artist, I can't remember. But that's the guy from Love Island. And essentially, all it was doing is giving them the necessary context in order for them to make a viral video super easily without having to put too much thought into it. So, on the right is something saying, oh, your friends are like this. And then it gives you a thing what your friends think you are, which basically is just shareable to your friends. And you say, oh, you think this of me? That kind of thing. And then on the left, it tells you, gives you a fake rating. And one of the fake ratings is like, oh, you're a liar. And it could be like, you put that on your friends once they, if you, they tell lies all the time, for example. So yeah, nothing crazy. Second of all, make it shareable. What about your campaign meets when you want to share it? On the left and the right, you've got my crying eyes filter, which I mentioned previously, which is all about the storytelling. How do you attach these weird, messed up eyes to a story that you had with your life? So on the right there, it's like when your mum's been gone for too long and you feel like she's gone into an accident, and it's like the crying eyes. And on the left there, it's about sort of this person that's been is pregnant and sort of having to cope with the emotions of being pregnant. So let's have some think about it when you start a campaign. Is it funny? Has it got high scores of some kind? Is it some sort of game where you need to get a high score and you can show off to your friends why it's that you beat them all? Or is there some sort of competition element? Are you just going to tell them, hey, if you share this on social media on Twitter, then we're giving away some sort of prize to your users? Next, you need to make it quick to access. So Zappa makes it super easy, luckily. So you can just scan the QR code and then it will load up with just one launch page and then you can get straight into the experience. But don't put a bunch of random forms before the main content. I keep seeing these experiences that have like pages of text and then they want you to type in your email. They want you to verify your phone number. They want you to do everything. You probably don't need to be telling them all about your products when showing them the before you even let them play the campaign. So just don't bother. You can add some at the end, but it's really about being sort of subtle and not overdoing things like the branding. So people don't like ads that just feel like ads. People don't want to be playing stuff and sharing stuff when there's a bunch of like logos everywhere, hidden all over the place. It feels like most of your screen's taken up by ads. If you overdo it, people are just going to click off and not share. On the left here, we have this campaign that we actually ran for the Women's Euros this year. And instead of like putting a bunch of Women's Euros logos all over the place and making it all about like the footballers and showing their face and stuff like that, we instead made you like recreate a footballer's poses, celebrations, I think it's called. So we had a bunch of different footballers and their celebrations, all animated with this weird football man, and made a GIF where they do the animation and you can follow it alongside. On the right there, as I mentioned before, you may not even realize that this is a campaign for Jiggle Jiggle or for Louis Theroux, but tied with the music, plus with the album art. So whenever you see the album art, you connect it directly back to the filter. And likewise, when you see the filter, you're like, oh, that's some Jiggle Jiggle from the thingy. And also even subtle things like on the license plate, it says Jiggle on there. So, I mean, let's fix up an experience. Let's take an experience that I've made as a demo and let's make it more fun and playable. Let me see if I can share my screen. This is the live demo portion where it's going to turn into a nightmare. Ta-da! Actually worked first time. Wow. Awesome. So I'm just going to build out what this current example of this product is, just to show you it kind of works. It's fine. It's an experience, but it's not something that would be shared or used everywhere. Let's load this in.
This is built in Zappar Studio, right,
This is
Ollie?
Zapworks Studio, yes, for this example. Yeah, everything here is using Zapworks. So first of all, you've got hello and welcome to Ollie's Beans game. First of all, this is a giant wall of text. You don't even know it's an AR experience at this point. If you've been sent this QR code or you've scanned a QR code on the back of a piece of packaging, you don't know what you're playing. This is just a wall of text. There is some useful text in here which tells you about the game, what you have to do, but also it's just promoting the actual company products and all that kind of stuff with no actual real context of the wider thing. It almost feels like you're just reading like through a form. You click continue, and there's another one of the sort of holes you fall into, which is enter your email, which at this point, if I saw this as someone that scanned a QR code, I'd be like, I'm not doing that, and click off the experience. So that definitely needs to go. We're going to jump into the experience now, and it's going to quickly run through, and it's going to be super quick. So get ready. There we go. That's the entire experience. I made it super, super quick. So, but you may notice right at the top, the entire like first 40% of the screen is covered by Ollie's Bean Catch Game, which is the logo all the way at the top. And then at the bottom, the entire bottom of the screen is taken up by this logo that's been made. This covers up literally the majority of the screen, and at this point, it's just way too much advertising. The end screen pops up and it goes, oh, you caught the bean, buy some of these beans. But that didn't even really feel like a game. That realistically, it just felt like you're just playing for a marketing experience and people are trying to get you to buy more things. There's no reason to share it, there's no excitement behind it, and it's just not that interesting of an experience. Obviously, this is massively hyped up to what some other experiences, but I've seen some people release campaigns like this, and it's just not that exciting. And then they're confused why didn't this do very well when we got releasing it?
Ollie,
So let's.
can you run it one more time? I think it
I
just kind
absolutely
of
can.
skipped as you were eating your beans, and maybe
Oh no! There we go.
there you go.
There we
Perfect.
go. Yeah, you can see me eating the bean there. Perfect. Awesome. So the first thing we're going to change about this game is definitely the introduction. That introduction was super, super long and was unnecessary. So let's give this a go. We're going to upgrade it in like four pieces today. So first of all, I'm going to upgrade the intro, then the main gameplay loop, and then the ending, and then sort of the extra bits and pieces that make it a bit more shareable, just to see how this works. There was no bean in the screen. Oh no. Well, there we go. I've replayed the bean there. Okay. Awesome. So first things first about this is I've made the background slightly transparent. Therefore, now whenever everyone opens the game, they can instantly see it's got some sort of augmented reality. It's a bit more personal. There's stuff going on. We're not just like showing a massive form here. You can actually tell instantly this is some sort of augmented reality experience or at least some sort of face filter experience. The text has been brought down to a tiny, tiny bit of information, which just tells you exactly what you need to do. And also the branding on the logo is way smaller. It's not taking up the whole 25% top of the screen now. It's taking up a little tiny portion. So if I click continue, it's the same experience as before. Catch the bean. Hop. And there we go, across the beam. Next up, what I'm going to add in is I'm going to remove this really gross branding from the top and the bottom of the screen. Let's do this by quickly swapping it out with the new falling. Remove the overlay. And this is a really good example of how you can integrate your branding into projects without it feeling like you're, oh, we're going to be having a live demo moment. Come back. Okay. This is a really good example of how you can integrate your branding and your product into your scene without it feeling like you're have showing them a bunch of adverts. So here at the bottom, we've had the beans can now integrated into this. And this is sort of for two reasons. Number one is it's showing off the product rather than just having a giant logo everywhere. Number two, it actually adds, well, you'll see in a second, it adds a bit of the story and context to the user. Very minimal. Again, I said it doesn't need to be, it's Lord of the Rings. If I press continue, it will show you the story and the background. And that is that this bean can has just exploded. And that's the reason why we're eating the bean the entire time. So there we go. You've got that context of this is why you're playing the game. It makes it a bit more of the game, gives you a bit of the backstory, and it also tells you to buy sort of the can just because it's got the can in it. The next thing we need to do is add some more excitement to the actual falling. I mean, that falling, it was fine. It did the job, but I mean, there was only one bean. It wasn't much of a game. It was more of just like a buy my product, look, here's the product type experience. So I can go ahead and add even more playability to the game once I get frozen on my face. Yeah, this is all built in Zappar Studio. So that's super, super fun. And unlocking. And there we go. So I'm going to show you, walk you through this now. There's now going to be multiple beans. Up here, you've got the timer, which counts down, which adds a bit more sort of excitement to the game. How many beans can you catch before the timer runs out? And then at the end, we've got a brand new end screen, which is like way more shareable and replayable. So let's give this a go. Beans explode. Drop down faster. And wait, we caught. Oh, did I not activate the. This is a. Did I activate the end screen? I did not. Okay, let me activate the end screen. But yeah, I mean, you get the example of how the actual gameplay now has been expanded into instead of just showing this one bean falling from the sky, you've got multiple falling from the sky and you can collect them all before being revealed your high score. Let's get this updated with the outro in it. There we go. Let's give this a go. Let's catch our, see how many beans we can get. There we go. So at the end now, you've got your score. So you got 3 beans. I've actually added something here, which is like share a photo to win prizes. Now what we, you can do that to make it so more people share it. Like in the end, you can tie a hashtag to your photo and then have a competition online where you can share it and whoever gets the most high score, you can like send them a can of beans or something if it's relevant to this campaign. But let's just click on the take a photo here and let me actually activate the take a photo, in fact, because that's not activated either. Brilliant. And step by step, we will get the final experience. I think this should be the final experience now. Should have used Universal Way R for the instant replayability, the instant reloading. There we go. Awesome. Now we can actually take a photo. And as you can see, even on this screen, I haven't like overdoused it with branding or made it feel like it's an ad or anything like that. I've added a super simple Instagram-esque filter to it where I've just added this face paint of the actual beans can on your side of your faces. Now, this makes it feel like it's you're just like showing off a cute face filter and you're taking a selfie rather than you just like promoting a brand. So let's take a photo here. And there we go. You got your I score, so it tells you your score that you got, and also it tells you where you got that score from at beancatch.com, which would be the domain that I'd be hosting this under. So for the user, I mean, there's two things, reasons why you would share this. Number one, it shows off your score. It shows off, oh, I got this high score. Number two, you got this great selfie that you've just taken that you can then share around with all your friends. And then for us as the sort of brand, you've got, oh, you could be sharing this at beancatcher.com. So every single time this is shared, it's linking back to the initial campaign. So it has that sort of ball rolling effect where the more people that share it, the more people are going to see it, and it can branch out way, way further. And also, Zappar has a great built-in feature where during in the share, you can actually tag what you want it to also fill to like something like Twitter or Instagram. So say we want a hashtag where it's like hashtag bean catcher game, you could have it also fill on the share button that's there. And then yeah, your users would instantly have the hashtag filled out. And then as a brand, you could then go through those through all of the hashtag and sort them by the people with the most score and then give out prizes and all that kind of stuff based on that. Awesome. Let me switch over to beans do mean prizes.
I spent about 5 minutes trying to find the perfect bean gif and I couldn't find it, so I never posted
Well, there we go. I can make you an Ollie's beans gif, which I actually spelt Ollie's wrong when I was making this, and I just thought it was funny, so I kept it. I think it works well. Awesome. Yeah, I've got a bunch of time now actually for questions. So if anyone has any questions, I'd love to hear some. I've also added my LinkedIn there if anyone fancies that as well. There we go. There's a beans gif in the
Joke,
chat.
Alan. I was going to ask Ollie, I don't know if there are any questions that have come through yet, but so feel free to pop them in either the live chat or the Q&A section for those that are watching. But I was going to ask, in your opinion, kind of how important do you think that gamification and the replayability factor is for making something go viral? And have you seen things or experiences that don't have that replayability that can still?
So I think replayability is a lot less so than just the general shareable aspect. I feel like if you make something that you can play through once, but it's really, really shareable, and that people have this urge to beat you in it or some sort of gamification of it, it really, really pushes it because everyone's slightly competitive. Everyone wants to beat everyone else, especially if even if you just like tag an influencer and get it as a brand, get an influencer to complete the challenge and they purposely get a low score, then a bunch of kids will go, oh, I bet I could beat this influencer that I like, and then play through the game and get a better score. So just having that, even that tinge of competitiveness to the a campaign, I feel adds so much to it.
Yeah, makes sense. Nice. I was also going to ask, just me being nosy, how long did it take you to put together your bean experience and where did you come
Oh.
up with that idea?
When I was making this presentation, I saw that old Snapchat beans experience that I made, the machine learning one. I was like, okay, this is the perfect thing. I didn't want to out any companies in the making of this. So I was like, okay, what's something that someone I've never worked with before in my life, and that's a beans company. So I thought it would work perfectly. The actual experience itself literally only took maybe like a day to make for both sides. I had the initial experience, which is like the bad experience, and then the better experience, and I sort of broke it up into small blocks so I could instantly swap out really quickly.
Yeah, well, it looks great. A lot better than the original bad experience, which was
Well,
also very good.
thank you very much. So if anyone from Heinz is here and wants to buy it, then you can get involved.
very cool. And did I pick up that that car jiggle jiggle was Jason Derulo, Louis Theroux,
Yeah, it was a
and
very odd inbox and very odd Google Meet session, which, yeah, Louis Theroux and Jason Derulo, he did a remix of the Jiggle Jiggle song that he did on Amelia's Chicken Shop Dates. And yeah, it was with Jason Derulo. Very odd.
That's the strangest crossover I've ever heard, but
Yeah, it was a
worked.
very odd session, but
very good. Well, we've got Ollie for another 5 or so minutes, so please do pop any questions you have. We'll leave this open for maybe another couple of minutes, and if we don't have any questions, then we can call it early. Was there anything else you wanted to add, Ollie?
no, I think that's about it. Yeah, just any questions really. Yeah, I mean, you can find all my socials below as scanning the QR code bar in AR, so QR code.
Nice. And I guess it might be worth mentioning the kind of web AR aspect of it and the ease, the shareable elements. I mean, I know you've already mentioned it, but that, I mean, a couple of years ago, 3, 4 years ago, it was all app based and then things went to the web. And I know you do a lot in the social apps as well, but I guess, do you have anything to say on the ease of actual launching of the experience? Does that have an effect? It can be the most,
Oh,
I guess, have all the viral
absolutely.
aspects of it, but if you can't launch it in any way, then.
Yeah, I think for in my opinion, I feel like if it's an app based brand campaign, I feel like it needs to be something that people come back to all the time. It needs to be something huge. It needs to be something like IKEA Place, because otherwise people aren't just going to go through the hassle of installing your phone. That a barrier to entry is huge. Something like Zappar is amazing for creating web-based experience and these marketing experiences, because it's so easy to use. All you need to do is scan the QR code, especially if on the back of packaging, and it's not directed at a certain very specific target audience. Then it reaches everyone almost. There's other different social platforms, and all of those have their own little niches of like what age brackets they're set to. TikTok is a wider one now, because everyone and their mum's using TikTok at this point. But things like Snapchat, we use that a lot when aiming towards like Gen Zs, and Instagram is like more and more millennial aimed at this point. And yeah, it's very you have to sort of figure out what platform you're going for based on who you're aiming at, as such. But Zappar and a bunch of their web technologies are really good at taking everyone for a quick experience.
Perfect. All right. Well, I think we can call it there, but this was awesome and I definitely learned a lot. So I hope everyone else that joined today did as well. These sessions are recorded, so if you did join halfway through, then all of the sessions from AR Pioneers will be uploaded to the AR Pioneers page, which is zappa.com/AR Pioneers. And yeah, if you have any questions for me or if you have any questions for Ollie, please do reach out, or anything about Zappa, please do reach out. Either on this platform or Ollie had his link on screen. And yeah, we'll hopefully
Awesome.
see you in some other talks. And thanks again, Ollie. This was awesome.
Thank you very much. Thanks for coming, everyone. Cheers. Bye.
Thanks, mate.